As a captain, you have to make sure you stay calm under any pressure situation and you make right decisions. You try to make right decisions and then just back your decisions.
Saad has done a great job so far, and he's a top cricketer, and he performed when the team needs, and I think everybody loved him.
So we cannot train outside, you know how the weather is during the winter time. So we really need to go to a place where we can play outdoor, because the best training is playing in like a match scenario, games outside.
Hello everyone, Adris Malik here with a special transmission and a special episode on a Canadian cricket. In this respect, I am thankful to Mr. Saad Bin Zafar, captain of a Canadian cricket team. Definitely he's a Pakistani born guy, but he is fully Canadian and living here. Thank you very much, Saad, for being us and giving us a time. So what are your thoughts for 2 days camp? I will start from here.
So we had a good training session today. We are actually training for a World Cup qualifiers playoff tournament that's coming up to qualify for the 2023 50-over World Cup. So we are actually training 4 days a week for that. So this was just part of that preparations of going into the World Cup qualifier tournament. So it's been coming along really nicely. We are training hard. Boys are in good positive space. We have had some good recent tournaments. So everybody is putting in their effort, and we are quite confident that if we keep on practicing and training hard, we'll achieve our targets.
Saad, I give you some of, like, between the time, I will give you some of the hints about his performance and his upcoming. Like, he's playing cricket back in 2010, if I'm not wrong. But after a comeback, he became a captain of a Canadian cricket team. And in the recent tour, they have a good performance, not only the Saad, but his team fellows under his captaincy against Oman and UAE cricket team, which is very much good. Upright in the ranking of ICC. So Saad, the next important thing is for you people is to play the qualifying round, preparation of qualifying round in Namibia. And before that, you are going to Sri Lanka. So do you think that this entirely change of the weather from winter to the tropical, it will help to prepare for the Namibia?
Indeed, we are in a winter period here in Canada, so we cannot train outside. You know how the weather is during the winter time. So we really need to go to a place where we can play outdoor, because the best training is playing in like a match scenario, games outside. So I think Sri Lanka is a best spot for us, because our coaches have a Sri Lankan background. So he has organized a really good about 20 days training camp, where we will be playing around roughly 4 matches against the Sri Lankan development squad, and then the rest of the days we'll do our own training and we'll have like center wickets to train. So I think that is the best training we could get before going into the World Cup. So I think it is very important. It's if we just train indoor here, just in the nets, and then go into a tournament, it will be very hard to participate and play against countries who are already playing outdoors and having that warm weather to their advantage, right? So it's very important for us to have that pre-tour going in before going into that tournament.
Saad is a left-hand batsman and a left-arm orthodox bowler. So I will have some questions. Saad, what do you think? Like, what sort of techniques you are following, and is there everything is going in the right direction? For me, it's 100% accurate, but player know how to analyze himself and what improvements, what are the area he need improvements. So if I ask this question to you, first you have to elaborate your batting, and then you have to tell about your captaincy.
So in terms of batting and bowling, I try to make sure that I do my basics right, which is keeping a balanced head and balanced stance, and I make sure I'm not rushing into things or getting into awkward positions. So if I'm staying balanced and I'm watching the ball till the end and I'm playing late under my eyes, I do those basics things right, I'll have better chance of connecting the ball. So in the indoor nets here, like when I'm batting, I make sure in training that I just do those basics things right, and then also you create scenarios in your head where like you plan whether you want to play an aggressive game in that net session, or you want to play defensive and play along the ground. So I practice those scenarios going into any practice sessions here. same goes with my bowling as well.
So what about your captaincy? Like, it's your big experience that you have played. Like, for me, like, the playing against the UAE is a big thing. Oman, I'm not rating like that much, but because they played like T20 the first round, so that's why this is a different story about the Oman team. So how you are thinking, like, what improvements you need before going the next qualifying?
So in terms of the captaincy, you just have to make sure that everybody's is gelling together, there's no issues in the team, and also you have to make quick decisions, but you also cannot show too much expressions, especially if you are under pressure, because if you show pressure and it from your body language, it shows that you are under pressure, it will like rub off to the whole team. So as a captain, you have to make sure you stay calm under any pressure situation and you make right decisions. You try to make right decisions and then just back your decisions, whatever you have made in the ground, you just back your decisions and then just go with them. But before that, you have to make plans, and you make plans for different bowlers and different batsmen, and you discuss and give plans to your bowlers, so everybody's, before going into a game, they know what plan they have and then they can try to execute in the game. So we have all the plans already set up, but in the game, during the game, we just try to execute the plans that we have already made. If plan A doesn't work, then we go on plan B, and if plan B doesn't work, then we change the plans. But already everything is being discussed in the training, in the practices, in the team meetings before going into the game, and then we just go into the game and we try to execute that on the game.
Okay, guys, before moving forward, I have some questions for the coach regarding Saad Bin Zafar and upcoming tour. Oh, your camp or tour in the Sri Lanka will help you?
Definitely. I mean, Sri Lanka is going to be a more tougher conditions, like, you know, when you talk about the weather part, it's going to be hot, humid. But I want that the group to go through that, like, you know, we're going to train hard during that period in that weather. So that will help us to build our fitness levels and basically everything. But when it comes to the Namibia conditions, pitch conditions and stuff, I'm fully aware of Namibia conditions because I've been there for a few times. So I'm going to get those conditions, similar conditions in Sri Lanka, telling the curators to make the way that we want. So I think it's well planned, just waiting to execute that.
Coach, like, in terms of execution, like, when you change the captain, Saad Bin Zafar become captain, and after that your tour to Oman and UAE, the matches are like extremely different than the previously. So how you are looking for this captaincy of the Saad Bin Zafar and the future of Canadian cricket team, especially in terms of qualifying round for ICC World Cup?
Saad has done a great job so far, and he's a top cricketer, and he performed when the team needs, and I think everybody loved him. I mean, he's been respected in the group the way that he handled things. So that's what you actually need to get the best out of this group. So everything is going pretty well regarding that. So I mean, when you talk about the Canadian cricket, the future, we want to get through to the ODIs in Namibia. That's the first step. Canada is a place where there's so much of talent. Even the youngsters, like, there's so much of talent. Even this, when you talk about the senior team, it's a big pool of good cricketers, and it's very hard to, even for selections, like, there's a lot of quality cricketers in Canada. So we need a good system in place. Once we get the ODI status, we'll get more cricket coming. That will help actually to develop our the bench strength. So looking forward to all these plans, though, but don't want to talk too much about the future, because the first thing is for us to get this hurdle in Namibia.
Back to the Saad Bin Zafar. So Saad, no doubt you are doing indoor practice. In terms of infrastructure, the Canadian cricket team is struggling, like, from last 10 to 12 years, and still there is ODI status and other things. There's a need of the time, that because everybody loves cricket, living in Canada and in North America, like other parts, like 8 million people are living here. So what do you think about the infrastructure, that how it is damaging the Canadian cricket team and the performance of the Canadian cricket team?
Yeah, definitely we are short of the infrastructure. The demand is of playing cricket is going is on the rise. I think it is the fastest growing sports in the country at the moment if you look at the numbers. And it's so the infrastructure is not enough to meet the demand. So obviously they need to improve the infrastructure. They need to build more grounds, build even stadiums. We don't even have one cricket stadium at the moment. And even they need to build a facility where we can train indoors during the winter time, because we understand that the weather is not the best and conducive to playing cricket, but at least if we have like a proper big dome kind of a facility, indoor facility, we can train there during our winter time. And then also if they have enough fundings, then they can also send us outside somewhere to train or to play games during the winter period. If we somehow find and manage a way to play all year round, I think our cricket will improve. Right now, most of the time when we struggle is during the winter time. If we go into a tournament during summertime, we do good because we are already playing cricket here. But anytime we have to go into a tournament which falls in a winter period, we always struggle because most of the time we go from indoors, then we go outside and play cricket outside. So I think, and even in the tournament that we're going to, if we get the ODI status, we will start getting more funding from ICC. I understand that right now they struggle with raising sponsorships because we don't play cricket enough. Our games are not televised on the TV or like live streams and stuff enough to attract sponsors. But I believe if we get the ODI status in the tournament and the upcoming tournament that we're going to, everything will change. We'll have more sponsorship pouring in. We'll have more funding from ICC. So hopefully Cricket Canada then will use and invest those fundings into developing infrastructures and doing things which will help and promote our current cricket. And I also hope that the government sector steps in as well and provides Cricket Canada with more facilities so the grassroots cricket can improve.
Saad, very important thing that you have said, that ODI status and the infrastructure and the support from the government, all these three things, and the fourth one, that's the pillar of in a sports games, that's a sponsorship. Definitely sponsorship is very important. If I ask about the strength of the bench, so what's the bench strength do you have in your pocket, and what you are looking for, like the junior ones? What's your hopes?
I think we have a really good squad and a very balanced squad. I'm fortunate enough to have some really good, talented guys and hardworking guys. But the good thing about us is we bat deep. Even our number 10 batsman can bat properly. So the batting strength is there. And even in bowlings, I don't go with just five bowlers. We have a bunch of all-rounders in the team. So even in the bowling terms, I have a variety of bowlers. So I think I have a well-balanced side, and I'm pretty sure that if we just execute our plans properly on the day of the game, we will do good.
So if I ask about the targets, like what are your targets from the Sri Lanka and the Namibia for in terms of ICC T20 World Cup 2024?
So right now we are just focusing on the 50 over World Cup, the 2023 World Cup, to get the ODI status back. So for that is the reason why we're going to Sri Lanka. So in Sri Lanka, I know the competition might be quite tough, because obviously Sri Lanka is a full Test nation country, and even their development squad could be like could have people, players who have already played for Sri Lanka or just knocking the door to get into the Sri Lankan team. So it's not about getting beaten or something. It's about playing quality cricket. So we just want to make sure that when we go to Sri Lanka, we get quality training and we play quality cricket from our end, regardless of the result. And I think if we are able to do that, I think we will be in a positive and a good mental space going into Namibia. Because in Namibia, the competition would not be as high as the teams we will play in Sri Lanka. But I think we are playing quality cricket, I think we will be in a good mood to go into the tournament in Namibia. And then in Namibia, if we beat Nepal or PNG, one of those two teams, we will get the ODI status. But then if we finish in top two out of the six teams, we will get to the next round, which is the World Cup qualifiers in Zimbabwe. So we are looking forward to that, not just to get the ODI status, but we're also looking to finish in top two and then go into the next World Cup stage, which is in Zimbabwe in June.
I appreciate your stats, your odds, and your table, that how you are correcting it, like to link it with the ODI World Cup qualifications. Saad Bin Zafar, Pakistan Super League chal rahi hai. पाकिस्तान सुपर लीग में बहुत सारे जो चाहने वाले फ़ैन हैं उनके तारुफ के लिए मैं ये पोर्शन जो है इंक्लूड कर रहा हूँ, क्योंकि साद बिन ज़फ़र गुजरावाला में पैदा हुए, उसके बाद लाहौर में कुछ देर रहे, फिर या ज़ाहिर आप कैनेडा में क्रिकेट खेल रहे हैं। साथ कभी कभी दिल नहीं करता कि यार पाकिस्तान सुपर लीग में बड़े बड़े प्लेयर खेलते हैं तो मुझे भी कोई मौका मिले, कोई चांस मिले, कोई ऐसा मतलब मौका गुजरा या कोई ऐसी उम्मीद?
जी बिल्कुल, मैं ड्राफ्ट में मेरा नाम होता है हर साल, लेकिन क्योंकि मैं कनाडा में रहता हूं तो मेरा ड्राफ्ट में जो नाम आता है वो डोमेस्टिक प्लेयर में नहीं आता, वो इंटरनेशनल कैटेगरी में आता है। तो जब आप इंटरनेशनल कैटेगरी में होते हो तो उसमें आप कंपीट कर रहे होते हो बाकी सारे टेस्ट नेशन से भी, मतलब इंग्लैंड के प्लेयर्स भी वहीं उनके नाम है, साउथ अफ्रीकन प्लेयर्स के भी उधर नाम है, तो उसमें आपका पिक होना क्योंकि लिमिटेड स्पॉट होते हैं तो उसमें आपका चांस कम होता है। बट आई स्टिल ट्राई, मेरी एक दो दफ़ा बहुत क्लोज रहा पिक होने से बट नहीं हो सका। बट करंटली मैं KPL कश्मीर प्रीमियर लीग हुई थी वो खेलने गया हुआ था, उसमें मेरी मैं मुजफ्फराबाद टाइगर्स एक टीम है उसके लिए खेला, मोहम्मद हफीज़ हमारे कैप्टन थे, मिसबाह उल हक हमारे कोच थे, सईद अजमल हमारे बॉलिंग कोच थे, तो उन सब में मेरी परफॉर्मेंस माशाल्लाह से बहुत अच्छी रही। मैं सेकंड नंबर पे था मोस्ट इकोनॉमिकल बॉलर ऑफ द लीग पूरे टूर्नामेंट का, तो मेरी काफ़ी अच्छी परफॉर्मेंस रही, सारे मेरे से खुश थे। तो होपफुली उम्मीद अभी भी जारी है कि नेक्स्ट ईयर इंशाल्लाह PSL में अगर कोई मौका मिले तो पिक हूँ और PSL खेलूँ।
देखें ये कुछ चीज़ें इन्होंने बताई, इनका ताल्लुक हफीज़ से, मिसबा से और सईद अजमल से। सईद अजमल कोचिंग कर रहे हैं इस्लामाबाद यूनाइटेड की, हफीज़ इस वक्त कोयटा ग्लैडिएटर में खेल रहे हैं। तो साद, ये छह टीमें जो हैं मतलब जो पाकिस्तान सुपर लीग की, तो आपको क्या लगता है आप कौन सी टीम आपकी फेवरेट है और आपका प्लेयर कौन सा फेवरेट है?
पाकिस्तान लीग में मैं क्योंकि लाहौर से हूँ तो लाहौर कलंदर को सपोर्ट करता हूँ, लास्ट ईयर वो जीते भी थे, तो ये है कि लाहौर कलंदर और शाहीन अफरीदी को ऑब्वियसली क्योंकि वो उधर से खेलते हैं तो मेरी सपोर्ट उधर है।
राणा ब्रादरन सुन लें, आतिफ राणा साहब, समीर राणा साहब आप मैनेजर हैं, तो ये मैसेज स्पेशली मेरी तरफ से है, साद बिन ज़फ़र जो है वो आपको सपोर्ट करता है, तो दिल इसका लाहौर कलंदर के लिए धड़कता है, तो दमादम मस्त कलंदर है, तो सोचे ज़रा आप वो सारे डेवलपमेंट स्क्वाड और इधर उधर से आप अभी DVD लेके आए हुए हैं, वो जो प्लेयर हैं वो भी खेल रहे हैं, तो साद बिन ज़फ़र भी हमारा ही हीरा है, इसकी भी बड़ी ज़रूरत है, इसकी ग्रूमिंग की, इसकी क्रिकेट को मज़ीद चार चांद लगाने के लिए हेल्प करने की। साथ बैक टू द टॉपिक, सो वंस अगेन, लाइक व्हेन आई सी इन योर टीम, लाइक यू हैव अ फास्ट बॉलिंग, लाइक गुड पर्सन्स इन योर टीम, सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक, लाइक दीज पीपल विल हेल्प यू, एंड इज देयर नॉट अ नीड ऑफ द रेगुलर ट्रिप्स टू द कंट्रीज लाइक पाकिस्तान, इंडिया, UAE एंड श्रीलंका?
Yeah, I mean, that would be an ideal situation, but we don't live in an ideal world. So, yes, that would be perfect if we can get and arrange those tournaments. But again, just because we don't have enough fundings from our board that they can manage all those tournaments, that's why we are limited to only one or maximum two tournaments before like an actual tournament that we go to. But that in an ideal world, yes, that we something we would look forward to, that we go in countries like West Indies or Pakistan or Sri Lanka, we tour them to get more training and play more competitive cricket and even get better.
Saad, in your team, like 2-3 players back, like they have like some links in Caribbean cricket, so why you people are not like thinking about that you have to be involved in the Caribbean sides and regularly like tour, not just for Jamaica and other, like I mean to say you have to like with the West Indian cricket board?
Yeah, so we actually did used to have like a ICC America combined team, which was a combined team from America and Canada, and we used to go and participate in Super Najico, which is a 50 over tournament, a domestic tournament in West Indies. I think for the past 2 years they didn't have it, and this year Canada was looking into putting a team there, but the dates clashed with one of our tournaments that we were we were going to Oman maybe, and the date clashed, so we decided not to go, but I think that is still like Cricket Canada is looking into that, and I think that would be actually very good for us because we learned a lot when we were playing in their domestic competition, and that helped our cricket a lot. I think it still comes down to maybe lack of funding, because even when you are supposed to go and play in that domestic tournament, you have to give some money to the West Indies board, and you also have to bear expenses of traveling your players to West Indies and all that. So I think it all comes down to the money aspect at the end of the day. You need fundings, the board needs to have money to be able to spend and organize and arrange all these tournaments.
I'm going to wind up last two questions. One question is related to, like, as you mentioned that you people are looking for funding and the tours. In the next calendar year, you have a lot of things to do. Sri Lanka, Namibia, then ODI status and all other stuff. So what are your thinking that how you will achieve in the step by step if you give me some schedule?
So this year we have a few things coming up. So one is the Namibia tour. That is for the 50 over qualifier. So once hopefully we achieve our ODI status, and if we finish in top two, then we go in the next round, the actual qualifier in June. Then we have a GT20 tournament that is our T20 tournament that happens, which is going to happen this year sometime in July. And after that, we have the World Cup qualifiers for T20, which is the 2024 T20 World Cup. The qualifiers will happen in Bermuda in September, I believe. So we have that one to look forward to. Those are the four key tournaments that we're looking forward to. If we do get the ODI status in March, then our ODI calendar will start as well in 2023. So we will start touring the ODI countries maybe from somewhere like sometime after June or July, maybe. So that will come into play as well.
Lot of hopes, lot of wishes for you, Saad, and your team. And final question is regarding your captaincy. Do you think you are now fully gelled with the boys and everything is going in the right direction and you need some confidence to take this team like next 2 years?
Yeah, so I've been playing for Canada for a very long time. I debuted in 2008, so it's been about like good 12 years, I would say, 12, 14 years. So most of the guys, I've been playing with them for a very long time, so it's not like I'm somebody new coming in. So I have like a very strong bond with most of the guys, and they all respect me, they all listen to me. So I haven't had any issues when I did my captaincy last tournament, and everything went really well. So they're all like well-respected people, and I didn't have any issues. So I'm looking forward to having another good tournament, and then I don't want to think too far ahead, but I will just go a tournament by tournament. If we keep doing our basics right and we keep playing quality cricket, I think everything will take care of itself. So I just focus on just playing good cricket in the field, try to make right decisions, and I just try to be honest to myself without doing any favoritism to anybody. I'm trying to be honest to cricket, and I think if I just continue to do that, God will reward you. God will take care of everything else for you, actually.
Thank you very much on CL24 and Crantline, all the platforms of websites and everything. The fertility who is living in this North America is not a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 persons. This is 8 million people who belongs to the cricket-loving nations. So they love cricket, they need some sport, and they need some sort of things that will flourish, that will help to flourish this Canadian cricket team. So until now, from Adris Malik, my request is to you, comment on my channel, and your comments will help for the betterment of the Canadian cricket team. Keep watching CL24. Thank you very much.